Today, we're gonna see if we can use focused sunlight to fire a bullet. This is a bullet, a 22 caliber bullet, and this is our solar scorcher. And today we are going to see if we can use the solar scorcher to focus sunlight to fire the bullet. The idea here is pretty simple. We have a small metal plate that we'll rest the bullet on and focus the sunlight by tipping our solar scorcher. We want to know if the sunlight will be enough to get the bullet to fire. This plate doesn't really hold the bullet much. It just keeps it from rolling so that it will end up exactly where we want it to go. This cord is attached to the top of our solar scorcher, and by pulling on it, we can tip the solar scorcher until it's focused right where we want it. The cord is going to be pulled from about 50 feet away inside the cover of a concrete dome, which is perpendicular to the path of where the bullet is aimed. Even if the bullet managed to shoot with the force of a gun in our direction, we'll be behind a concrete wall about a foot thick. We also have a couple of pieces of foam core, and we're just going to set those up behind and in front of our bullet to see if it happens to shoot straight enough to pass right through. Now, because this plate isn't holding the shell in place, it is pretty likely that the shell and bullet will shoot off in opposite directions with approximately equal power. Of course, all of that's assuming that the sunlight is enough to set it off in the first place, and I think it's time we do a test. First, we're gonna remove the bullet and put a small stick in its place. We'll test pulling the solar scorcher with the rope, seeing if we can angle it just right so that it starts burning that stick. That's gonna be how we know if we have enough heat on it to try and light up the bullet. It certainly lights that stick up pretty well. Now let's try it with the bullet. That's a fire. I don't know where the pieces went, but here's the bullet part. I don't know what that hit. Or like if it just popped apart. But I have to watch the footage. You know, even if it does that 50 times, I'm not gonna stand out here next to it because you never know, that one time might be bad. Ooh, but there's an impact mark. Is that from the shell? Maybe the bullet hit that and bounced? Interesting. There's a slight impact mark. Doesn't even go through to the other side, but something hit it. Interesting. Oh, the shell. This board has nothing except, well, it does have a couple of tiny spots, but those might have already been there. I guess I didn't pay enough attention to that. Let's check the footage and see if we can figure out what happened. No way to tell where it went. To me, it looked like both pieces went that way, but wait, did we see the bullet land back on here? Let's try this again. Kind of surprised it takes as long as it does. This solar scorcher can actually melt a bullet shell, so it's possible I don't have it focused quite right. Getting the height is really tricky. There it goes. Oh, last time we had an impact, this time we caught the bullet. Oh, that's great. So not a lot of force on that bullet if it can't even shoot its way through a single piece of foam core. It dented the back, but it didn't make it all the way through. Oh, there you go, magicians. That's how you do a bullet catch. You just have the bullet not be in a gun. Set it off with the power of sunlight and catch it in a piece of foam core. Nothing could be easier. It did go pretty straight. That was almost exactly where it was aimed. Of course, it also hit the foam core sideways, so it was tumbling a bit. Lack of rifling will do that. And I really just don't know what happened to the shell. It didn't leave a mark, so it didn't shoot off straight backwards unless it ran right into the wood. Oh, maybe it did. There's a little chip in the wood. Right here, that's pretty in line with it. Oh, that is probably it. Man, that didn't just shoot the bullet, that is destroyed. Wow, so not being contained in a gun, that just exploded. That is cool. I'm gonna move the foam core to the other side of the wooden leg support. That was quicker. Ooh, we got a good focal point on it. Okay, we definitely caught the shell with the board this time. In fact, I believe it shot right through. So that's the most powerful impact we've had with a piece of foam core so far. The bullet didn't make it through. This last shot, I don't see any indication of where the bullet hit. I think we just lost it. Maybe it went off sideways, I'm not sure. But the shell looks like it launched right through, and so I'm not sure where it would have ended up. Probably didn't get too far given how much power we've seen that these things don't have before, but exploded nicely. Setting off bullets with the power of sunlight, definitely possible. But now I do want to take it one step farther, and rather than just setting the bullet on top of this metal tray, I'm actually going to try and grip the shell in the vise itself and see if we can get it to shoot with the force of a bullet. We've got a couple pieces of veg tanned leather right here, and we're just using those to help grip the bullet shell more evenly so it's not just biting into the rim. See the leather smoking.
Random fact, the average bullet travels at 2,500 feet per second, which is roughly twice as fast as the speed of sound.
Yeah! All right, we got the bullet to fire. The leather dropped out and the shell is not here. I was hoping we would end up with just a shell being held in the vise. I need to try squeezing a little bit harder. As for the bullet, let's see, did we hit our... I don't see any indication of a bullet mark on our board here. So I'm gonna assume we missed. Oh, here's one little chip. That might be from a bullet. That might have just been a scratch. I'm not sure. It's also possible if the shell is exploding, if the shell explodes, it doesn't really matter how well it's being held because there's not much shell left. Bam! Fire's quick when it's properly focused. Smells like burning leather, delightful. Still no indication of a bullet impact. And once again, the leather was blown clear and we have no shell. Let's try again and squeeze it down even tighter. Bam. All right, even with all that, we still lost our shell. Not seeing much in the way of an impact spot. Like, not so much as a dent, really. Sunlight and bullets. Can you use concentrated sunlight to fire off a bullet? Turns out, yes, you can. It fires just sitting in a tray, it fires held in a vise. We did not get any results that indicate that you can get a bullet to go where you want it by using sunlight. We could probably build a nice little complicated mechanism that holds the shell on almost all sides, but just lets in enough sunlight to set it off, and maybe then we could get it to shoot in a nice straight line. But overall, I would say this is a terribly impractical way to shoot bullets. The sun moves, or more accurately, we move in reference to the sun, and that makes it so you have to realign your solar scorcher, your magnifying lens. Like every couple of minutes, we're just having to move and adjust and move the solar scorcher, move the vise, move the bullets back and forth. So it can work. I don't recommend it. In fact, this is not really a super safe activity, so there's no reason to do this anyway. But we just wanted to know if it was possible, and it is. The solar scorcher does get hot enough to ignite the gunpowder within the shell and fire off the bullet. Although, like we saw, not with much force. It almost managed to pierce a piece of foam core, which I'm pretty sure most people could punch through. So it does fire, just not with as much power as you might be interested in. Guys, thanks for watching, but the fun doesn't end here. That box up at the top will transport you directly to our last video, and you should check that one out. The other box will show you what YouTube thinks you should be watching next. And if you haven't joined the club yet, hit this bomb to become a subscriber, and that way you never miss out on the fun. Don't forget to ring that bell, and we'll see you in the next one. Talk to you then.